I'm Carson Holbrook.
I'm Micah McCoy.
And this is Youth on the Hill. So, with Thanksgiving coming up, I have a few questions of the type to ask you.
Okay, Thanksgiving questions.
What's your favorite Thanksgiving food?
My favorite Thanksgiving food. I've heard this is just an Ohio thing. But my favorite Thanksgiving food, Carson, is mashed potatoes, and noodles. Yep, you heard that right. Mashed potatoes, noodles. You take your mashed potatoes, whoosh, you put the noodles on the top, whoosh, you mix it together. Sometimes you might throw some corn in there too, and it's good.
I've had that a few times. It's pretty good, but sometimes the noodles are just a bit too moist when you put them on the mashed potatoes.
You don't want moist or soggy noodles.
Ew! Like, it just kind of messes it up, you know?
Yeah. No way, Jose. Get those out of there. Kick them out.
Kick them out?
Kick those soggy noodles out of town.
Kick them out.
What about you, my dude? What's your favorite Thanksgiving food?
My favorite Thanksgiving food is something that a lot of people disrespect at the Thanksgiving table, but it's the rolls, you know?
You think people disrespect the rolls?
Oh, yeah. They toss them aside like they're nothing because you got the ham, the turkey, the green bean casserole, the green beans, all that stuff.
Yeah.
And they forget to give the rolls some love. And sure, it's been the most consistently good thing throughout my life.
You know, you're right. You're right. There is always rolls at the Thanksgiving table.
Oh, yeah. And you can do so many things with them.
Yeah.
Because you can just eat a roll straight up. And then you can chop it in half, put whatever you want inside. Yeah. Preferably butter for me.
Sure.
And just eat it.
So this year, when you viewers are sitting at your Thanksgiving table, Carson, you and I sitting in our individual homes with our families, don't disrespect the rules.
Don't disrespect.
Let's, you know what, Carson? Let's give a moment of silence for the rules. Okay. Okay, the rules are your favorite. All right, next question.
My second question for you, Micah.
Yes.
Do you listen to Christmas music before or after Thanksgiving?
Listen, so I know out there in society, this is a very hot topic.
It is.
In most years, I am one of the ones who makes the decision, has the conviction to listen to Christmas music after Thanksgiving.
Okay.
I'm going to wait till after Thanksgiving. What
about
you?
Smart choice. Personally, I always have to listen to Christmas music after Thanksgiving. Recently, I've caught myself trying to hum Christmas music, and I just say, shut up. Nope. Nope. Like, the dude next to me is like, what the heck are you talking about?
Yeah.
Like, I'm just like, shut up. No.
Like, no.
No.
No Christmas music allowed until after Thanksgiving.
After Thanksgiving, it is perfectly fine. But then after Christmas,
yeah.
After Christmas,
yeah.
You have to stop and then wait a whole
year. I have a cousin, Carson, who listens to Christmas music and watches Christmas movies all year around. Yeah.
That is.
Should he go to jail?
Yes.
Put that sucker
in jail.
We should
legally make that a crime.
Yes. Make that illegal.
No hate to your cousin, but full hate to your cousin. he should be put in jail for life.
For life.
But like, not like full on jail where you have all those terrible people, but like just like juvie. You know,
put him in juvie.
His parents. Just,
you're going to juvie. You're going to juvie.
There's some restrictions. And stop him from listening to Christmas music ever again.
Yeah, okay. His name is JJ. So, JJ?
JJ.
You're going to prison.
Yeah, for life.
For life.
For life. So, with Thanksgiving coming up and youth church was this Sunday, and didn't you guys talk about giving thanks?
We did. So, this past week, Carson, we talked about thankfulness. And we talked about basically making sure that we keep our mind set on the positive things and not the negative things, and choosing to be thankful and grateful even in a world that is so angry right now with the election or COVID or whatever. There's all this ungratefulness, all this unthankfulness. And are those words ungrateful, unthankful?
Ungratefulness and
unthankful. I think they are. Yes, I think they are. So there's all that unthankfulness, ungratefulness going on in the world and how we should choose to instead be thankful at all times. And I had this little saying, Carson, and it was this. It's really cheesy, really dorky little saying, but it'll help you remember. I gave everyone donuts. And I said, throughout your life, make it your goal to see the donut and not the hole. Okay? So it's really dorky, but throughout your life, make it your goal to see the donut and not the hole. Because, Carson, if I were to walk up to you and be like, here's a donut.
I'd take it.
You'd be like, yeah, love donuts. Do you like donuts?
Oh, heck yeah.
What's your favorite kind of donut?
Favorite kind is a, it's a Long John, what I call it. Where
okay.
It's about... that long, sure. It has chocolate on top, and then in the center is cream filled.
Sure, sure.
It's amazing.
So, but if I were to just hand you a glazed donut, would you like that?
Yeah.
You'd be like, oh, I'll take that all day long. Yeah. So, but in life, though, we typically, God gives us things in our life, and we're like, you know, that's great, but I don't want that because it's missing something. Mm-hmm. Like a donut has a hole in the middle of it, and it would be absurd if I handed you a donut, if you were to just whack it out of my hand and say, oh my gosh, I can't believe it. You would offer me a donut with a hole in it.
Disrespect me like that.
Yeah, it would be ridiculous if Carson was like, found it disrespectful for me to give him a donut with a hole in it because it has a hole in it. But often we only see the hole. We only see the things that we're missing in life. We don't see the other things that God is giving us. Mm-hmm. And right now, with COVID going on, you know, you might be missing certain things you would normally get with school. Maybe you're missing certain sports activities, certain social gatherings, and you're just so focused on the things that we are missing. And it's really easy to do that right now. But I was basically just encouraging the people on Sunday night, and I'm encouraging anyone who might be watching, to instead of seeing the hole, instead of seeing the things that you're missing, to choose to see the donut. Look at the things that God is giving you. And we talked about in our small group time about how when you do that, when you choose to see the things that God gives you, it makes you much happier as a person. Mm-hmm. And when you choose to just focus on the positive instead of dwelling on the negative, the things that you're missing, you begin to be more of a much joyful person. And so I just kind of encourage you to do that. I encourage mm-hmm. the viewers to do that. And I've been thinking about it this week, thinking about, okay, Micah, how can you dwell on the positive and the things that God has given you instead of dwelling on the things that you might be lacking in your life?
You know how, like you said, a lot of people right now aren't putting their main focus on God because of the election, COVID, and all these things that could be going on in their lives. Like, you have any tips for them, like, to help? How can they help themselves focus on God mm-hmm. instead of all these other things?
Maybe some tips on how to do that?
Yes.
How to focus on the positive?
How to focus on the positive.
Sure. Sure. Well, reading and praying, doing things, spending time with God, that always helps, of course, mm-hmm. And focusing on that. Having yourself surrounded by positive people, right? Negativity is contagious, and positivity is contagious. If you're surrounded by people who are constantly like, oh my gosh, I hate school. You know, you're going to hate school.
Yeah.
Because all your influences around you are being negative.
Oh my gosh, I hate COVID, or I hate our president, or I hate this, I hate that.
You're going to eventually begin to have a negative outlook yourself.
Yeah.
But if you make yourself surrounded by other people who are choosing, you know what, I'm not happy about COVID, but I get to spend more time with my family right now. But, you know, we get to still go to church on Sundays, and that's awesome. You know, people who focus on the positive, so surrounding yourself with people who are positive, people who choose to look at the positive things in life, surrounding yourself with God's word, the Bible, that is constantly positive, speaking truth over your life, instead of filling your life with negative influences, negative things on social media, you know, negative things, negative TV shows or movies that are negative for your influence in life. Just practical things like that, surrounding yourself with positivity. And then it's honestly a choice. Right?
It is.
We have to choose to look for the positive instead of looking for the negative. But you can make some practical adjustments, like surrounding yourself with people. And we talked about that a little bit in our small groups. Mm-hmm. But it's honestly a choice you have to make every day. You're gonna choose to look at the donut, not the hole. Choose to look at the things that God is giving you, instead of the things that you might feel like you're missing.
That reminds me of a quote from The Dark Knight, where I think it may have been Harvey Dent who said it. He's like, all it takes is one bad day to drive like the. I forget exactly what it was, but essentially it means all it takes is one bad day to turn like the brightest, best person you know into a dark, terrible, depressing person. Because it's just that choice that you have to make, or that certain outcome that makes you think that way.
And we need to make sure that doesn't happen to us, right? Mm-hmm. We have to make sure we don't let that one bad day turn us around. Because we all are going to have a bad day.
Oh, yeah.
You know? We all are going to have days that just are terrible, or things go wrong, you know? And we've all had those days where literally everything in the day goes wrong.
Oh, yeah.
and in those days, though, you choose, okay, am I going to let this destroy me, destroy the rest of my week or my month? Or am I going to say, it's just a bad day? Mm-hmm. You know, we all have them.
Persevere.
Right.
And I think it's something that you can take from a bad day is learn from that experience and put it towards your next day. And whenever you have a bad experience, just look to the positive instead of the negative.
Sure.
Like, giving thanks and looking at the donut instead of the hole.
Right. Exactly. And the Bible talks about that actually over and over, about how God takes what the enemy meant for evil and he turns it for good. And he always does that, right? No matter what the situation in life that happens to you, you might not see it at the time, but if you just keep walking with God and keep persevering in your life, God will turn it around for the better. He'll work it out for the good, whether you even see it in your life or not. He's in the business of doing that, turning things around for the good, even if they initially started out as something that would harm us or hurt us.
Sure. Because he's always looking out for us, you know. It doesn't matter where you are or who you are. He loves you.
Yes.
And he's going to try his best to protect you no matter what, because he's our God.
Right.
You know, he's been looking over us since before we were here, before we stepped foot.
Yeah.
Before our ancestors. It's amazing.
Yeah. And that alone is something to make you thankful.
Mm-hmm.
Right? If everything goes wrong in your day, everything falls apart. In our nation, in your world, in your school, in your family, in your personal life. If everything falls apart, you can rest and be thankful in knowing that our God is still good.
Oh, yeah.
And that his love is still constant. And that he still remains our awesome God.
Thank you guys for joining us this week on Youth on the Hill.